गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू क्लास 7 साइंस वंस अगेन। चिल्ड्रन, इन अ प्रीवियस वीडियो वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट चैप्टर नंबर 14, इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एंड इट्स इफेक्ट। ओके, सो विल कंटिन्यू दिस चैप्टर। टुडे विल डिस्कस अबाउट द हीटिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। ओके, व्हेन द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज पास थ्रू अ वायर, for example filament, so it heats, okay, it heats up. This is the heating effect of electric current. Okay, we'll also discuss about conductor, insulator, resistance. Okay children, so let's start. So first of all, we'll discuss about conductor, insulator and resistance. Conductor are those substances or material which allow electric current to pass through them. Okay, for example metals, while insulator are those substances which do not allow electric current to pass through them. Okay, example wood, plastic, distilled water. Clear? See on your screen, some substances allow electric current to pass through them. They are called conductors, for example metals. And some substances do not allow electric current to pass through them are called insulator. Okay, insulator example wood, plastic, distilled water. Okay children, now next, that is resistance. Resistance is the property of a material by virtue of which it opposes the flow of electric current through it. Okay, the property of material which it opposes the flow of electric current, this is called resistance. Okay, and the unit of resistance is ohm. Okay, now the most important topic of the chapter, that is heating effect of electric current. When electric current is passed through a high resistance wire like nichrome or copper, the electrical energy is converted into the heat energy. Okay, clear? I repeat once again, when the electric current is passed through a high resistance wire, so the electrical energy is converted into the heat energy. Okay, and result of this, the wire will heats up, and this is called heating effect of electric current. Okay, see here, the wire will become heat. Okay, this is called heating effect of electric current. Okay, so the one activity that will prove that when electric current is passes through a wire, it become heats up. First of all children, take an insulated copper wire and remove the plastic cover both the ends. Now take a cell and connect the two end of the cell of the two wire. Okay, of the two wire. I repeat once again. Yeah. So first point, that is take an insulated copper wire and remove the plastic covering from its end. okay. Second, take a cell and connect the two ends of the cell of the two end of the copper wire, okay. The two end of the cell connected by the two end of the wire. After that, insert a bulb between the cell and conducting copper, okay. A bulb will put, then after, if we supply the current in this circuit, so the bulb will heats up and this show the heating effect of current, okay. We can touch the bulb and we feel heat at that time, okay. Little heat that are produced by the bulb because they have the low magnitude of heating element, okay. Children, yeah, the amount of heat produced in wire due to heating effect of current, okay, and depends on the resistance used, the magnitude of current passed through it, okay. So the heating will depend on the magnitude of the resistance, okay, clear. Now next, that is application of heating effect of current, okay. Which application? Electric iron, electric room heater, immersion rod and electric toaster. These appliances are working on the heating effect of electric current. These appliances have high resistance of filament, so they produce the more heat as compared to the bulb. So children, all these appliances have a coil of high resistance wire called heating element, okay. So which is made by nichrome, that is a combination of nickel, chromium and iron. So when electric current is passed through such electrical appliances, the heating element become red hot and produces heat, okay. And this is the heating effect of electric current, okay, clear. Some more example, like electric bulb, will take electric bulb, you know very well, which is used for producing light and also experiences heating effect of current. Inside the electric bulb, a very thin resistant filament are there, that is made up of tungsten metal, okay. So the thin wire is there of filament produce the less heat, okay. Basically electric bulb used for lighting, okay, clear. Now children, you know very well also about CFL, okay. The wastage of electricity can be reduced by using the fluorescent tube light and CFL. So they do not have the filament, so that's why they do not produce the heat and they do not work on the heating effect of current, okay. These are very safe, they do not produce the heat, so they can use for lighting purpose to save the electricity, okay, clear. Now next, in the figure you can see that the figure of electric bulb and then the figure of CFL, okay. Now next, that is short circuit and overloading, okay. Next one, that is short circuit and overloading. Short circuit, you know very well, short circuit, that is when an excessive flow of current occurs in the circuit, okay. Like for example, we have the electric circuit that can be suitable for the 200 volt electricity, but if 300 or 400 volt electricity will come, then it may cause the damage to electrical appliances, those are running on that circuit, okay, and they can also catch the fire. So in short circuit, the excessive flow of current occurs and it may cause damage to electrical appliances and they can also cause a fire, okay. Now see some example here, short circuit, the wires in electric circuit have three wire, live wire, neutral wire, earth wire, okay. So due to defect or damage wiring, the live and neutral wire touch with each other and they cause the resistance of circuit become almost zero. So a very large current flow in causing what is short circuit. Short circuit may lead to the overheating and electric fires. Okay, so simple and very easy. That is, if excessive current will come in the circuit, so they cause the short circuit and they can cause the fire also. They damage the electrical appliances, those are running on the circuit, okay, and may lead to the overloading. Overloading, do you know children, overloading? Overloading, that is when an extremely large current, when an extremely large current is drawn when too many electrical appliances are connected to the single socket. Okay, like for example, in our room we have a single socket and by the use of single socket, we using the electrical room heater, electrical iron, okay, TV and many more. So at that time the single socket, that is damage, okay, the single socket damage and it can also cause the fire, okay. This is called overloading of electrical circuit, which can lead to the overheating and electric fire, okay. So overloading and short circuit is clear to you? I repeat once again, short circuit, that is when excessive amount of electricity flow in the circuit, it may cause damage to the electrical appliances, okay. This is short circuit and short circuit leading to the overheating also. Overheating, single switch connect to the many appliances, so that is overloading, okay. Next, that is electric fuse, okay. Some solution are there, okay. How can we prevent from short circuit and how can we prevent from overloading, okay. So the solution, that is electric fuse, that is a safety device, okay. Electric fuse is a safety device which work on heating effect of current. So when high amount of current will come in the circuit, so the electric fuse breaks the circuit, okay. It breaks the electric circuit, clear. But nowadays MCB, that is miniature circuit breaker, are used in place of fuses, okay. MCB that are very suitable. If high electricity will come, the MCB automatically turns off, okay. And when the electricity will neutral, when normal, then we can manually switch on the MCB and the appliances will work again, okay. So we can say that MCB are being used in place of fuse, as these are switches that turns off automatically when current in the circuit exceed the safe limit. Okay, when the fault of the circuit has been set right, the MCB can be reset in the on position and the circuits get completed once again. Okay, clear? So children, this is about heating effect of electric current that we have discussed today. Okay, thank you.